Does Hollywood really care about freedom of expression or human rights? It's self-censorship, record to please, China says otherwise. In the last few years, the overseas collection has become a critical, in fact, the most important component of earning for Hollywood studios. In 1991, only 30% of Hollywood's total monetary collection came from overseas. And today, it accounts for 70% of the total collection. The figures have reversed, and with this has come a major change in Hollywood's approach as it resorts to self-censoring to cater to large markets, specifically China. China, the largest trading partner of the United States and its arch enemy, has become the second largest market for American movies. The revenue from China is rising exponentially, and in 2020, the collection from China was estimated to surpass that of the United States. This had once already happened in the first quarter of 2018, when the total collection of Hollywood movies in China was greater than that in the US. But as China gives market access to Hollywood studios, the Chinese government has started using these culturally influential studios as a Chinese propaganda tool. The scriptwriters, directors, and production studios are forced to paint China and the Chinese government in good light. Otherwise, the Chinese government would ban their movies. Stanley Rosen, a professor of political science at University of Southern California, told CNBC, "You have to be very careful before you shoot a script, knowing how big the Chinese market is, to make sure you get China right." A report by Pen America talks about how Hollywood writers are changing scripts, deleting scenes, and recasting actors only to gain access to the 1.4 billion strong Chinese market. The Chinese Communist Party officials would not tolerate any mention of Taiwan or China's human rights abuses in Tibet, Hong Kong, or Xinjiang. These issues are completely avoided by the self-proclaimed flag bearers of liberalism and human rights in Hollywood. Their activism is restricted to Golden Globe speeches. This is why you'll never see a Hollywood movie on Tibetans losing their land, culture, and religion, or on Uyghur Muslims held captive in internment camps. There are many examples of Hollywood prostrating before the Communist Party of China. Hollywood is guilty of deleting Taiwanese and Japanese flags from the movie Top Gun Maverick. The movie Call Me By Your Name was banned for portraying homosexuality. Scenes from Men in Black 3 were also deleted. And the 2018 movie Christopher Robin was banned because its main character was Winnie the Pooh, who is often compared with Xi Jinping. The 2016 movie Doctor Strange had to change its character, the Ancient One, who was deemed a Tibetan. All scenes about her cultural roots were also deleted. Now, American Senator Ted Cruz is trying to make sure that Hollywood does not become the visual version of Global Times, the state-owned newspaper of China. And to ensure this, he has introduced the Stopping Censorship, Restoring Integrity, Protecting Talkies Script Act in the US Senate. Cruz said, "For too long, Hollywood has been complicit in China's censorship and propaganda in the name of bigger profits. The Script Act will serve as a wake-up call by forcing Hollywood studios to choose between the assistance they need from the American government and the dollars they want from China." The Pentagon assists all major studios of the United States as they make a large number of high-technology movies, including those about wars. The proposed bill would bar the Pentagon from working with production houses that do not commit to not bow to the Chinese censor board. For the last few years, Hollywood studios have censored many scenes to which China objected. And now, the scriptwriters have become used to self-imposed censorship. Now, to stop Chinese propaganda by Hollywood studios, Ted Cruz has brought this bill. The Chinese Communist Party spends billions and billions of dollars to mislead Americans about China and shape what our citizens see, hear, and think, he said, and also added, all of these activities are part of China's whole of state approach to amass more influence around the world through information warfare, and we need to put a stop to it. Before Hollywood becomes an extension of Global Times, the US government, as well as the intellectual establishment, media, and academia, have to rise against Chinese censorship.